You start in a dizzy, and you go to this portal, and you go through the portal, and I'm met by these people. Looks like this guy's in the control room, operating the equipment that makes the portal run. And where have you ended up? You've ended up in an underground facility. It's actually a city. And it's full of technology. It is not a human city. There is within the earth. But you can't get there through a tunnel. You have to go through that portal. It's quite civilized, really. I mean, these people at desks. Underground trees, a bit spooky. I wonder what light they used to grow. In general, business, day to day life down there is an acquired taste, I'm sure. Wouldn't mind visiting though. It must be quite spectacular. It's going to be tens if not hundreds of kilometers. And there's one of the occupants there. One of the founders of these cities. These are the cities that make it possible for our brothers, the reptilians, to survive cataclysms on the surface. And then pop out and meet the survivors with plenty of technology that they've had for thousands of years. And we don't have cities underground like this. Not like this. This is huge. This is just, it's like an ant's nest, but in a cavern. And you certainly want a directory to get around, because it's huge. Wow. It is massive. We'll go down to this area. Let's see what's happening here. There's plenty of activity down here. Indeed, these are the portals. So these cities are connected. And sure, he's in a telepathic chair. It looks like he's running this particular portal. And where is it going? this is Egypt. We're looking at the Akashic record of what happened in that place around 10,000 years ago. And it's quite a vivid story. So many people, so many different types of beings living on the planet. Unbelievable to our imagination. It's like whatever you've seen in Star Wars times 100. And it was right here on Earth. And it's been destroyed. Absolutely annihilated. As described in the book of Daniel, in the King James Bible. At the end of that book, they talk of a rock being hewn from the earth, not by human hands. And that rock became a mountain. Went over the whole earth. It's not Noah's flood. That was previous to this. This flood was like the mud flood from hell. Maybe in the next video we'll have a look at the remnants of the mud flood. Because it's there to be seen. And it's fairly evident that it was recent history.